What do you do when you need to build a chatting, or to be precise, a chatty application? An application where the API calls are very frequent. For example, a chatting application here where Alice wants to send message to Bob and Bob wants to send message to Alice, or it can be a gaming application like chess where Alice and Bob are playing chess and they want to communicate using some backend service. And there are a lot of options to do that. One of those options, and by far the best option, is WebSockets. There are other options as well, like long polling and WebRTC, but that's for another day. In this video, I am going to build the most simple application for WebSockets. The clients will be written in, well, nothing. The clients will be the browser console where I'll create the connection using the browser console, and the backend will be written in Java. The backend will also be one of the most simple backend where you'll have maximum 3 to 4 classes so that you can easily understand what is going on here. Now let's get started with the architecture of our application. The architecture of our application is quite simple. We have a backend and we have clients, and the clients want to communicate with the backend using WebSocket. WebSocket is a bidirectional communication between the client and the server. So bidirectional means that a server can send the message to the client and the client can message to the server. And WebSocket connection starts as an HTTP request response handshake. The first call which is made from the client to the server is an HTTP request. A TCP connection is established, and once that TCP connection is established and the handshake is done, the connection is maintained, and then both the clients and the server can send the message to each other. And these connections are in fact perpetual theoretically, which means that they will break only if either Bob or the backend, that is either client or the server, break the connection or close the connection, or there is some network connectivity issue or the timing out issue. But in all the other cases, these connections are established so that both the client and the server can send the message to each other. So the cost of creating a connection is avoided in WebSockets. So a simple chronology: initial HTTP handshake happens, and then the WebSocket connection is established. And once the WebSocket connection is established, you can send and receive the messages. And once you are done with sending and receiving the messages, you can close the connection. Simple concept. Now let's move on to the coding part. So I will demo with the help of a Java application, and that Java application will be a Spring project. And in my Maven dependency, I'll have just one dependency, that is Spring Boot Starter WebSocket. So let's get started. This is the Spring and Maven based project which I have already created. I'll also put the link of this project on GitHub so that you can clone it and then run. Here I'll just go through the project so that you can understand what is going on here. You can create a Spring and Maven project easily and then add this dependency, Spring Boot Starter WebSocket, so that you can start with the WebSocket concepts. And then once you do that, you can annotate the main class with Spring Boot application and component scan. So this component scan will do one thing, that it will scan all the packages inside com.anubhav.websockets and all the classes within those so that the dependencies can be created. Then the second thing you need to do is you need to create a WebSocket endpoint. You can do that with @enable WebSocket. And here you can give the path, that what is the path. Just like in the REST API, you can give paths that this endpoint corresponds to this method. Likewise, the same thing is here as well, that I created a WebSocket handler method and I gave that the cross origin is allowed here. And this socket text handler class has been created, which will be mapped to slash user. So when I go to the browser, I make the request to the server, I'll need to make sure that slash user is there in the request URL. And this socket handler is created. And socket handler is a class. Here I'm extending text WebSocket handler. And all I need to do is to implement the callback methods. There are three callback methods I need to implement: after connection established, after connection closed, and handle text message. So after connection is established, I can do some of the operations. After connection is closed, I can do some of the operations. And whenever I get a message, I can run operations. So here I have a helper class so that I can manage all the sessions in one place. Whenever I get a connection being established, what I do is I add the session to the session manager. Session manager is a helper class which maintains the list of sessions. Likewise, I can remove the session. And whenever I get a message, what I do is I send message to all the other people. So that's the logic here being built, that whenever you get a message from someone, you just message to all the other people by iterating over all the sessions. So the session manager class is quite simple. It has one set, hash set of the sessions. Whenever a request comes of a new session being added, it adds to the same hash set. Whenever somebody closes the connection, you can remove that session from the hash set by iterating and removing. You can follow any logic you want to. And likewise, whenever we need session corresponding to a web session, that is, let's say somebody sends a request and I want all the other people except from my session, in those cases also I can get the list of the sessions. So it's nothing, it's overall maintaining a hash set so that in various use cases you can get the sessions and update the sessions and then send the message. So quite simple here. You register the URL and these callbacks method will be called whenever somebody sends the message. So in the handle text message, whenever from the browser I send any message, this method will be called. And then using this for each method, it will send message to other people. Now there are other concepts as well, which I have not covered here. That is, how do you do group chat? How do you do one-to-one chat? It's all broadcast here. But you can see that those things can also be managed using this filter method. So here, what I'm doing is just iterating over all the web sessions and then sending the message. But of course, you can have filters like, hey, if Anubhav wants to send message to Alice or Alex wants to send message to Bob, in those cases, just make sure that those filterings are done right. So those things are easily configurable. Now let's run it. To run it, what you need to do? You need to run public static void main, and the backend will spawn up. You can see my server has started on port 8080 localhost. Now we'll quickly move on to the browser session. You can open the browser console using these three dots. Click on more tools and then click on developer tool. A browser console will open where you can enter the JavaScript commands, as well as you can see a lot of developer options. I have already done that, and what I have done is I have opened two of them. One is for Alice and the other is Bob. Let's imagine left one is for Alice and the right one is for Bob. And the first thing we'll do is to create a WebSocket object. So we'll do is let WS equal to and the same thing we are going to do here. Let WS equal to. If you go to the network tab, you will see a connection got established here with a response code of 101. Now I'll do ws.onMessage. That is, whenever I receive the message, what exactly do I want to do? So I just log the data, and likewise I'll do for Bob as well. So till here, we have been able to create a WebSocket connection we have written a method that what should I do when I receive a message. Now we'll send message from one place to other. So Bob will send "Hi Alice, how are you?" And Alice receives the message. Now Alice will reply, and the Bob receives the message. So this message is coming using this callback method, that is ws.onMessage. So if you go to the network tab here, you don't see a fresh call. In the same call itself, if you go to the message section, you can see the data being sent as well as the data being received under the WebSocket sections. So in this way, you will be able to communicate from the same WebSocket connection. The to and fro of the messages will keep on happening, and Alice and Bob will be able to chat with each other. So here the request is going from front end to back end written in Java, and from there it is coming to the other user. So extremely simple example where I'm not using any third party library. I'm not using the fancy HTML, CSS, JavaScript, plain simple JavaScript command using which these two people are communicate with each other. All right. So we have been able to create the simplest WebSocket application where Alice was chatting with Bob and there was one backend machine. So Alice sent a WebSocket message to backend one and backend one sent the message to Bob and vice versa. However, there is one limitation to this system. This system is not scalable. There will be increase in the number of people using the chatting application when this application really grows. And in that case, one backend machine won't be enough. And you remember that the way we were keeping the web sockets was in memory hash map or hash set. And using that hash set, we were trying to communicate between Alice and Bob. However, if Alice wants to send message to Eve, how would she do that? Because Eve is connected to backend too. So in that case, we would need some mechanism for backend 1 and backend 2 to connect to each other. And there you can use something like publisher subscriber model. You can use publisher subscriber model using Redis. And I'll cover that in the further videos. I don't want to make this video complex. The intent of this video is to have a simplest example of WebSocket where you could create a backend using few lines in Java. And then you could create a front-end code using few lines of JavaScript, and then you can put connect the client and the server and then server to client and have a chatting application. Do clone the repo, which I would link in the description, and try it yourself. Once you do that, you will be able to understand the system better. I hope this video was helpful. Please like and comment if you like it. It really makes a difference. Till the next time. Bye.